Indian women cricket team coach Tushar Arora has resigned 5 months ahead of World Cup T20. We understand that this happened post reports of differences with team seniors. And sources say that this has happened after senior players voiced their concerns to the authorities with his training methods. And also losing the Asia Cup twice is being seen as his failure. Let's go across to Viren, who's joining us on the phone line. Viren, what really happened here? We understand that senior players are the ones who voiced their concerns to the authorities on his performance as a coach. And also the other important question that obviously comes up is who will take his place?
Well, that really remains to be seen, Avni. But in the immediate future, what we are left with is the fact that the Indian women's cricket team no longer has a head coach. This because the senior players in the Indian team virtually froze the coach out. There was no working relationship that was left between the senior players and the team, especially, and the coach himself. So Tushar Arora had little or no option but to step down. Now, this was, I would say, in the making for some time, because the coach was rather disillusioned with the way things were functioning, and it's not the best sort of way to be operating. Now, he is the guy who's been in charge, of course, for a while. But if your relationship with your players is completely broken down, there's little that you can do. While you'll also be asked questions about the performance of the team. Now, the performance of the Asia Cup wasn't something that the team was entirely happy with, and the blame for that, it seems, was pinned on the coach. And now we've seen him, in fact, take the step of quitting. It's been a while since India, in fact, lost the final of the Asia Cup. But I think Tushar Arora has spent some time thinking about this decision. It's coming in the making now for some time, to be honest. So it's no surprise that he's actually decided to put in his papers, having given up on trying to mend the relationship between himself and the players. And it's ultimately the fact that that relationship had completely gone into disrepair that Tushar Arora had little or no option but to put in his papers as coach of the women's team.
Right, and Viren, considering the fact that it's just 5 months before the T20 World Cup there, it is also extremely important that the new coach is chosen quickly.
That's right. You know, we have seen with the men's team as well when, if you remember, just a few months ago, when Anil Kumble was virtually frozen out of the Indian coaching position because his relationship with Virat Kohli had completely slipped. And it tells you that if the captain and coach aren't on the same page, don't respect each other's views, then there's little in terms of little good that comes out of that. And therefore, I think Tushar Arora himself has seen that it doesn't make sense for the senior players, the team, as well as him to be butting heads in the lead-up to a big event like the T20 World Cup. Remember, Indian women's cricket team has been doing fantastically well, and the result of the Asia Cup was like a bit of a blip for the Indian cricket team. But they're hoping that if they get a new coach in time before the World Cup, that it will iron out a lot of the issues and allow the players to do their best. So it seems in the best interest of the team and the performance of the World T20, this step has been taken.
All right. Thanks, Viren, for getting us all those details. That's the latest breaking news that we're getting you.